Now, from your weather authority, Chief Meteorologist Wayne Hart.
We're coming off a pretty nice weekend that featured dropping humidity levels. And yes, we saw a little bit of rain on Saturday, but that's the only rain in Evansville so far this month. Normally a dry time of the year, and fortunately we do have some significant rain on the way beginning Wednesday. And today's highs were pretty much close to normal, about 85 to 90 across the area. Evansville was the exception, the hot spot at 91, Henderson 88, Owensboro 90. We'll be about a good 5 to almost 10 degrees cooler here over the next few days as the clouds and then the rain chances increase across the area. But this evening, live first warning Doppler's all quiet. We had some very isolated showers this afternoon south and west of Evansville. We'll see a few more in our western counties tomorrow afternoon, and those rain chances begin to ramp up, peaking, it looks like, on Thursday, though they will be lingering into the weekend. And this is the estimated rainfall amounts for the tri-state over the last 7 days. And you can see there's been very little rain in southwestern Indiana. You can almost carve it out there with the Wabash and Ohio Rivers there. Evansville, less than a tenth of an inch, along with Newburgh, Henderson, Owensboro, just a little bit more. And the only parts of the viewing area that have really gotten significant rain, southern third of the tri-state, where there are some pockets of 1 inch amounts where you see the shades of green. So we really do need some rain, and there is some on the way. And the timing is pretty good because it does look like the rain chances will diminish some as we head into the weekend. Thule Injury Law Skycam looking down on the Evansville Riverfront this evening. Feels pretty good out there because of the lower humidity. We're at 76. Now, the dew points come up to 67, but earlier this afternoon, it was in the upper 50s, which is downright pleasant humidity for this time of the year. And we saw the north breeze coming in at 3 miles per hour. Low to mid-70s right now. We'll wind up in the mid to upper 60s by daybreak tomorrow, which again is fairly seasonable for this time of the year. We're in between systems right now. A big rainmaker up in the northeastern part of the country has once again caused some major flooding problems for the Northeast, something they don't often see in the summertime. Take a look at some of this video from eastern Pennsylvania from earlier today. River flooding, flash flooding, creeks and streams. Some of this is coming out of the suburbs of Philadelphia and then also up towards Wilkes-Barre and Scranton. North Jersey has had all kinds of issues with flash flooding. And again, it's not typical for this part of the country in the middle of summer. Normally, kind of a dry time of the year for a good deal of the country, perhaps the exception of the northern tier, but they've had, I think this is the third major flooding event they've had in parts of the Northeast. We could use a little bit of that rain, and as I mentioned, we do have a little bit on the way. We'll go back to the tri-state here, and you can see skies right now are mainly clear. Updated future tracker keeps it that way overnight, and then sunshine to start the day tomorrow. This is just patchy ground fog that you see right here. Clouds increase, though, southwest to northeast in the afternoon. A few scattered showers, maybe a thunder shower getting into southern Illinois by 4. And these are going to tend to dry up as they hit Highway 41. So we may see a little rain in Evansville. Better chances to the west. Not as hot, but more humid. Mid-80s for the high. Few scattered showers and thunder showers tomorrow night. Then they continue in a scattered fashion on Wednesday. Humidity is still there. It's going to be breezy, mid-80s again. As we head into Wednesday night and Thursday, more scattered showers and thunder showers across the area. Matter of fact, looks like better chances for some heavier rain on Thursday. That could knock our highs down into the lower 80s, but even more humidity. So mainly clear overnight, 65 to 69 for the low. Increasing clouds tomorrow. A few spotty showers in our western counties with maybe a rumble of thunder in the afternoon. Humid, but not as hot, mid-80s. Rain chances go to 55% Wednesday, 75% Thursday with very humid air, but the temperatures are coming down. And then the rain chances come down a little bit as we head into the weekend. But really 50-50 chances for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And the better chances Friday, maybe earlier in the day. A lot will hinge on the position of a front that is going to stall somewhere in the area. But temperatures, again, won't be bad, 85 to 90. And the humidity will be there, but at least those rain chances, after we hopefully get significant rain during the work week, will go down some over the weekend.
Hope so.
All right. Thank you, Wayne.